Welcome to the 28th Annual Chicago Tribune Printers Row Lit Fest, presented by Bank of America. We would like to give thanks to our sponsors and community partners who make this event possible, especially the Chicago Public Library. Before we begin, we ask that you please turn off your cell phones and all other electronic devices. Photography is not permitted. Please welcome Joyce Winicky, Associate Editor with the Chicago Tribune.
Could this be a better day for LitFest? Thank you so much for coming. On behalf of all of my colleagues at the Chicago Tribune, we work so hard, many people, toward this day, and we're very excited when it arrives. The Tribune is very committed to books, literature, good writing, and that's really why we're here today with the festival and why we have created Printers Row, the membership program, which is a weekly journal and a weekly booklet of original fiction and access to author events and other discussions about books and literature. So check that out. This program is obviously a highlight for us this weekend. I've been carrying around this copy of the Good Eating section from the Chicago Tribune. The lead of this story is one of my favorites. The queen of the 30-minute meal would like to direct attention to her buns. So let me now introduce Lourdes Duarte, who is co-anchor of WGN 5 o'clock news, who will bring you Rachael Ray.
Everybody, this is such a great crowd. How are you guys? Everybody's got their, you know, nice little summery shirts. You all look fantastic. Thanks for coming in, spending your afternoon here. Like I said, my name's Lourdes Duarte with WGN News at 5, which you all watch, correct? Yes, thank you. I saw somebody going like this. I'll give you a check later. Thanks. Okay, let's get right to it, because she's here, and she's delightful, and she's been kind of waiting here for this to get started, and it's such a pleasure to meet her, Rachael Ray, coming in today to talk to you.
I said, was it a good story? She said, no, it was really boring. I said, you should make one up. Hot sex, baby.
I was trying to save lives.
Rushing
into a burning building and ice cream.
Precisely.
So it's great to have you here in Chicago.
Great to be here. I love Chicago.
You do.
It's so beautiful. The big wide boulevards and the water.
And you came on a great, great weekend because we're having wonderful weather, so you'll enjoy it.
I know, it's
perfect
great.
Perfect for Lit Fest. All right.
So and my husband flew in today to surprise me on book tour. It's never really a surprise. Whenever I go on book tour, all I have to do is look at the list of the cities, and I know which one John will pick, you know?
That's a smart guy. That's why you married him.
So I put on extra hairspray, extra lip gloss. I'm like, John will be there. Of course, in this heat, it all melts off 5 minutes
that's
later.
That's true. It's all right, though. We love it. So you guys all have your burger book? Yes? You have favorite recipes? Because I like the buffalo turkey burger. I already picked
that's
my favorite.
That's one of the most downloaded ever. Mm-hmm. My husband's favorite is the blue arugula. It's cambazola blue and Worcestershire and parsley in the burger and balsamic caramelized onions on top of the cambazola and some spicy arugula. I like the Adirondacker because I'm from upstate New York. And I love the in the Sloppy Joe section, the messy Giuseppe warms my heart.
Why a burger book?
Categories that I use in my head when I'm writing, I have these notebooks that I carry with me every day, and I write in different categories. Make your own takeout, yes, or kids will eat it, at-home date nights, on and on and on. The burger category in my computer was literally like ridiculous. There was like 700 and something recipes mm-hmm. of burgers, sandwiches, sloppies, sides, anything hot dog related, slaws, fries, you know. And I thought, well, this is Burger and his buddies. We should do something with this collection. And every year at the South Beach and New York Food and Wine Festivals, we have a burger cook-off for the world's greatest chefs. We call it the Burger Bash. And I wanted to showcase all of our winners and highlights from that event and put them together with my favorites out of over, you know, 700 recipes. So there's about 200 of my burgers, 100 of Burger's buddies from me, and then all of our Burger Bash trophy winners yeah. are also in there. All of our, you know, Mike Simon, all of our great chefs that participated in that event generously gave us their recipes for the burger book too. And then I saw the Book of Mormon and I laughed so hard I thought I was gonna pass out. And I said, oh my God, that's what I call the Book of Burger.
Book of Burger.
You know, choirs sang and, you know.
Light bulbs went off.
Exactly, and I saw this glowing burger on a book cover. And it's a really fun book, and it's the first of what I hope to be many of what they call smart books. If you scan the QR code with your smart device on the back of the book, you get every burger and burger-related recipe that I've written since I delivered the manuscript. So, and all throughout the book, there are little QR codes that'll give you different little fun videos or messages or reasons why I asked different friends of mine to write burger essays in the book. So it's an interactive book, and I love anything that keeps books in print interesting and relevant mm-hmm. And part of the century that we're yeah. in, you know. So I really love the design of the book, and I thought this was the right time. You know, we went through and still are in a struggling economy, and I think one of the very few on a very short list of benefits to going through that as a country, as a nation, is that it drove a lot of us back into our kitchens and back into family dinner. And it drove chefs to the streets with their food. People, the first thing that goes when you're tightening your budget is, of course, the luxuries, going out to dinner and going to fancy restaurants. So you had this sort of glut of great food and great chefs and great cooks taking their food to the street with these food trucks all over the country. And that's what this sort of cuisine is. It's everything you can think of. There's beef Wellington burgers and filet mignon burgers and seafood burgers and tuna and salmon and scallop and shrimp and whatever. It's everything in the world made accessible and affordable and fun and casual because it's on a bun or a little slider roll or something.
And one of the things that I want to mention, that even though it's called the Burger Book, it goes beyond that. I mean, I was looking
it's
at
not
some
just,
recipes
right, ground beef
for,
on a bun,
you know,
right.
Fries and some other great things that
yeah,
you
yeah, it's
really
all
like.
Of Burger's little buddies. Mm-hmm. It's the fries and the slaws and the sides and the dogs and the my favorite recipe actually in the whole book is not a burger at all. It's my 7-hour brisket.
7-hour brisket.
Hell
do tell.
Yes, it is so good.
Do tell.
It is just, it's got a rub, it's got beer, it's got this crazy barbecue sauce and a horseradish sauce that goes on the bun as this slaw salad. It's just deep. It made me believe that my husband still loved me after all the years Ooh. We've been together. We're gonna stay together forever now that I came up with that 7-hour brisket sandwich because he's hooked.
Oh, I bet.
It's terrific. And my husband, he got one of those egg smokers, and he just loves anything that'll keep him outside all day in the backyard with the dog, standing next to that egg. He loves babysitting the 7-hour brisket. So.
And not to jump ahead too much, but you started talking about your husband. You guys are actually working on a book together.
Together.
This is the next book. Just give us
this
a quick
fall,
tease.
This fall, the book that we'll come back to Chicago for in November and December is My Year by me and my husband's My Year in Cocktails by John Cusimano.
Oh, nice combo.
Yeah,
I see
we're
going to
do a little flip cover. Actually, for the last more than a year, about 2 years now, we've been photographing with our little Leica camera everything that we make at home mm-hmm. and keeping food and, in his case, beverage journals of every single thing we make, breakfast, lunch, and dinner for all of that time.
That's a great idea.
So I gave the 2 years to the editors and let them decide, you know, where to start and where to finish. Same thing as this book. You'll be able to scan the back and everything that we make from the time we delivered the manuscript, which was just recently, mm-hmm. through when we launch the book this winter, you'll be able to see all those different weeks, everything we made in between.
That is such a
So it's a great,
thing.
You know, value of a book, certainly. And it gives people like a scrapbook of what I actually make when I'm at home.
Okay.
And we entertain a lot because I need, there's just two of us and a pit bull.
Well, because it's
so I need somebody to feed.
You want to go to our house and eat, right?
So there's a lot of great meals in there.
One of the things I was thinking about while I was as I was looking at the book is, you know, you've partnered up with the First Lady on healthy eating
yeah.
and exercising and, you know, working out.
There's a lot of healthy burgers in the book,
lifestyle.
Too.
And yes. so that was going to be my question, the fact that, you know, sometimes we think of burgers and we don't think healthy.
Well,
to me, when I have a burger, it's
There's
high calorie
vegan count. And vegetarian mm-hmm. and chicken and turkey. There are also really rich burgers. You know, it's changing the idea of what a burger can be. You can make a burger out of anything, out of grains and vegetables and ground white meat, chicken and turkey and all of this. But I think, you know, and I'm sure that the First Lady agrees, and I've seen her speak about this point many times, is that, you know, if you move, if you get some exercise and you eat a healthful diet overall, we can all enjoy a burger or a dog or a French fry, you know, from time to time. You just can't have those things at every meal, every day. You have to, and you know, if you are gonna have a burger, I am of the opinion that it's a much more healthy choice to prepare it yourself. You control the salt, the fat, and the quality of the ingredients, and your portion size, and all of it, you know. So if you are going to have, especially fun foods or casual foods or foods that people consider taboo if they're trying to watch their diet or their weight or their exercise program, I think if you are going to have a fun food, let's say, if you make it yourself, you can feel a lot better about that because you know the quality of every ingredient involved.
So give us an idea, if we are going home tonight, looking through the burger book to make one, how do we make it healthy? How do we make it something
Well, there's
that,
a ton of healthy choices in there. I mean, you know, a ton of them. If you eat gluten-free, like I just cooked for all the ladies of The View. Any of the burgers in the book are fine for Elizabeth. She just puts them on a gluten-free roll. Barbara liked the chicken spanakopita burger. I mean, it's all white meat chicken and spinach, a little bit of feta cheese. The ingredient list is healthy, therefore it's a healthy choice in the burger, in the book of burger. If you're going to eat a ground meat burger, I think it's really kind of fun to go to the counter in the regular grocery store, you know, get to know your butcher and mix and match different meats. I make my own burger blend at home. And I bring home a piece of chuck, a piece of brisket, and a piece of sirloin, and you can coarse grind it, or they can do it for you there if you want. If you have one of those big stand mixers, they sell for not a lot of money, the little meat grinder attachment that goes on the front. And my grandpa always made all of his own food because he had 10 kids, and he grew most of his vegetables, and he had rabbits and birds. Mm-hmm. And when he would buy meat, he'd buy it in big pieces and grind it up himself and make sausages and hamburgers and all that kind of thing. So, I mean, it is fun to sort of mix and match
yeah.
your own burger blend, but if you're watching your fat content, you of course buy leaner meat. You know, you're going to buy it out of the case. I like ground chuck. So you just tailor it to your diet. I mean, you can make any of the burgers in there as healthy or unhealthy as
and
you
those
like.
Those pictures look so good.
I know,
I'm
they're good, right?
Right now.
Photographer did an excellent job. I really,
really
like extreme close-ups when it comes to food, and I like the food to look imperfect, you know, messy and kind of... Like, you really want to get in there. And
you always talk about the 30-minute meals. This is a perfect one.
Well, some of them actually take longer. I mean, it depends. There's something in there for everybody. I mean, I try and always put a lot of value into my books. I think that I write popular food, and it's like popular music. I don't want to outprice a CD or a DVD or something. I want there to be as many recipes and as much information as possible for the lowest cost. You know, I want to put as much value into every title as possible. For this, it was hard to just narrow it down from, you know, 7 down to 3 for me, and then we had all the Burger Bash recipes to cram in there, too.
Okay.
But the photography, I'm knocked out by. It's great. And I love the idea of these smart books. The fact mm-hmm. that the book comes to life is crazy.
Yeah, because for a lot of people, I think...
Christmas's book, I did the entire 30-minute meal section with no pictures and all video of commercial-free 30-minute meals with a little clock running that you could pause. And we got a really nice reaction from that. Mm-hmm. People really liked, like, the tutorial aspect. So in this book, I thought, well, I write so many burgers so often, and there's not a lot people can learn from actually watching a person make a burger. I mean,
right.
It's a burger. So I wanted to use the smart application for this book to just give more value. And as I write new burger recipes, it just keeps getting updated. So you have sort of a perpetual book once you buy it in print. It's a book that keeps on giving, you know, kind of thing.
All right, so you guys know what I did before I came here to talk to Rachael. I got on Facebook, of course, and I asked some of you to send in some questions or things that they wanted to know about Rachael, aside from the burger book. So, okay, question number one was, any plans for a restaurant, especially a restaurant
in
Chicago?
I'm trying. I want to do a slider bar, a restaurant that's primarily sliders and everything small, you know, little deviled corn dogs, little sliders. Flights of little, like mini pints of beers, flights of Bloody Marys on Sundays, and fountain drinks. There used to be a fountain girl at Hojo's. You know, flights of fountain drinks spiked for the grown-ups. I want a slider bar, but it's, I just can't find the right location yet. I've been looking for years in New York, and the other cities I'd like to do it in are Austin, Texas, Chicago, and I love Pittsburgh, too. I have a thing for Pittsburgh. So I think all those are very burger-friendly places. But
do you think it's something that might happen in the next year or two? Or
I've been trying for several years, so hopefully. We'll see.
Hopefully. Okay. What else do you have sort of in the horizon when it comes to the show or even the magazine?
We are about to shoot the second round of Rach vs. Guy, the celebrity cook-off show. We start that in another week out in L.A. this time, opposite coast this time. And then I do Week in a Day for the rest of the summer, which is the cooking channel / Food Network show where I make a week's meals in one day. I do that for about a month or so. And then in August, we go back for our seventh season of the daytime show, starting with our 1,181st episode will be the first episode. And we're in a brand new HD studio that's huge. So we're designing that set right now. So it'll be an all new HD house. So I will go and get a very long facial before that begins. yeah, and our efforts with our Yummo organization and our child nutrition initiative, they're going terrific. And anytime you see any of our products that have an orange burst that says Yummo on them, our entire bake line, some of our knives, we have kids' knives that have the burst on it, certain box sets of our pots and pans, bubble and browns, all that stuff. Whenever you see the burst, all of the proceeds go to our initiative. Our initiative has three tiers to it. It has a scholarship program, a type 2 diabetes and obesity awareness program, and a fund to help eradicate hunger. So the next door neighbor to obesity, ironically, among our kids is children at risk of going hungry. So that's doing really well. Andrew Kaplan, who runs our initiative, is here with me today, and he's done a fantastic job with that. I think that's about it.
That's about it, which leads me right into my next question, which was
question
number two.
And the Year in Meals book, we have another book tour this fall.
So. Question number two that people had is, how does she do it? And she's always so happy. How does she get all that done? And she's always smiling.
I think a big attitude adjuster for me was I was starting to get tired and a little overwhelmed, I think, with things probably 4 or 5 years ago. But then I had vocal cord surgery.
Right.
When I was a kid, I had croup a lot. And I got a little clogged gland in there. And once I started the daytime show, I would talk so much, it would swell up. And when I'd get this little bubble, you know, in my throat, not to gross you out, but I wouldn't be able to talk at all. I just couldn't, the cords couldn't go together. So I had this surgery where I had to shut up for 3 weeks. You can imagine how successful that was for me. And I started running out of, like, anger and frustration because I got sick of, like, trying to write down everything I was trying to say. And I was 40, so that was, you know, 3 years ago. And it really changed almost 4 years ago. It really changed everything for me. I get up 6 days a week and I do 4 to 5 miles on either a Stairmaster, an elliptical, or a treadmill, and then I do, you know, different exercises and weights after. It makes my head so much clearer and I have so much more energy and I stay in a more even mood. I really feel like I wasted about 20 years of my adult life, you know, not meaningfully exercising every day.
Did you not exercise before? Or you just
I figured
things?
That if I
that was good exercise enough.
And I did, you know, sit-ups and like Jane Fonda butt lifts and you know, like living room calisthenics kind of thing. You know, and I would do those, you know, like 4 days a week if if I was lucky. And I'm like, well, whatever.
That's
right. I'm like, dude, I'm up before dawn. I don't get home until late at night. Mm-hmm. I work all this. That's enough exercise. It really isn't. And I'm not talking about what size clothes you wear or how your pants fit. It's a mental thing. Like, I really think better working out in the morning and having that nice run. And I listen to music and I just zone out. I'm not thinking. I'm not like writing recipes in my notebook or answering phone calls. And when I'm not doing something like that and like blaring the Foo Fighters in my ears, I'm constantly working. You know, I'm not a good sitter still.
And it's part
person.
Of your personality too.
Yeah.
You're kind of outgoing. You like doing things. You like being busy and going and going.
Oh God, my honeymoon was excruciating. I tried to do nothing in Africa. I took like 785 pictures because I was like Hemingway. I was up every day at 4, you know, and out there with the guy with the shotgun and, you know, journaling. And I'm like, because I can't do nothing. It just doesn't make me happy.
But it's so hard sometimes to kind of get out of your own head. And you're right. Running does help, or any
type of
exercise,
really does.
Because it does make you clear your head a little bit, which is important.
And I love that time where I just get to listen to my music. And I'm a huge music fan. My husband, he's a lawyer by day, but has a band by night. And we're both huge music aficionados. You know, mm-hmm. We love every type of music. We go to the opera together. We love indie rock and, you know, we listen to a little bit of everything, and that time in the morning that I get to spend with my music and just running and like not thinking about anything is fantastic. It puts me in a better mood. That and enormous inappropriate amounts of caffeine, and then when I get home, red wine.
Red wine. All right, I'll throw a question out there, just kind of out of the blue. Red wine. What kind do you like? What's your favorite?
I was married in Montalcino, and that is the home of Brunello di Montalcino, a Tuscan red. So mm-hmm. Rosso di Montalcino and Brunello di Montalcino are my favorite. I drink in the summertime Sicilian rosés, and my mom's from Sicily, so we buy primarily Italian wines. But I am an equal opportunity drinker.
Equal opportunity. That's great. I think one of the things that people really love about you, and I know I certainly do, I'm a fan, which
Thank
is part
you,
of the
Lourdes.
Reason why when they said Rachel's coming into town, I'm like, I'll do it, me, I'll do it.
I love her, she's so cute. You just want to put her in your pocket, she's so cute.
You know, just the fact that you do have all this energy and you are always, you know, happy and
I get
you
paid
make
to,
us, you get us in such a good mood, I think.
Seriously, I get paid to do what I would do on a day off from any real mm-hmm. job. I mean, I chat and I cook. And everybody's like, oh, how do you do it? I'm like, are you kidding? Like when I used to have to open, you know, the market, you know, that I was working at when I was working in the production kitchen and I was the buyer out front, I'd go down there in my work boots and wear the same jeans 3 or 4 days in a row till they could walk by themselves, and, you know, in a white kitchen coat and be unloading trucks at 5:30 to let the staff in, you know, cook 60 pounds of chicken, 3 different
wow.
soups, 2 pastas, 4 veg, 3, you know, soups, and get the cheese order in the case, you know, take a break around 5 or 6, go home at 8, you know,
yeah.
make dinner, go to bed at 10. Like, those are days, you know, like labor-intensive days,
right.
you know.
Do you ever look back and think, wow, look at all this great stuff I've been able to accomplish. Look at what I've been able to do.
I love it, you know, and it makes me insanely happy to be proudly an American. I mean, you really can still start out a waitress and end up,
yeah.
you know, with a wonderful opportunity. And the whole talk show thing, I mean, everything that happened to me happened as an accident. I never wanted to be on television. I didn't know I was going to do any of this talk show stuff once I was on TV. And now I get to go to work and talk to Hugh Jackman, delicious.
Hello.
And then make dinner, too. I mean, you know.
He didn't come with you today?
You know? You know, they are the loveliest, he and his wife, his whole family, they are the loveliest, most normal, sweet, it is lovely to do that aspect of a job if you've been in food all your life, to sit down and, you know, get to know a little bit more about these people. And since we're not the type of show that asks them, you know,
right.
whatever tabloid question is out there,
right.
You know, I'm asking them what their favorite food is or their favorite color as a little kid or what they do with their kids last Thursday or whatever. To have that kitchen table talk with somebody and really get to know them, it's remarkable how, you know, how much your whole perception changes. Yeah. You're like, oh, wow, I wish I lived next door to you. Yeah. You're so normal and fun and nice. And
fun.
Yeah, it really is. It's a cool thing.
Well, we're all really glad that you came in and glad to talk to you. And we're, I think, all looking forward to going through the burger book, right? So they're wrapping
it's burger
it up.
Season!
A big applause for Rachael for coming in. They're wrapping me up so that she could do some of the book signing. So enjoy the rest of your day. Get outside.
We'll see you at the signing, guys.
All that stuff.
Okay, let's go.